everyone, welcome back. In today's video, I am taking you with us for a fall themed day in the life. This is the first official weekend of fall, and we are just doing a bunch of fall things, some chores, some for fun. As you can see, I am starting my day with a hot coffee, and I'm adding some whipped cream and cinnamon to make it festive and just super cozy. I do this kind of during the, I start with the whipped cream in the fall and do it sort of to Christmas. It's like my one fall thing that I just love. It's kind of decadent, but I just totally love it. As you can see, I get up before the kids, and this is typically how I do even on the weekends, and I just love having an hour or so to myself to just kind of wake up and do a little bit of work or whatever I feel like doing. Next, you can see we are having breakfast. The kids are up and dressed, and these pumpkin muffins they're having, oh my goodness, guys, they're so good. I made them the last few years and I'm obsessed. So I actually made these the night before, and I'm going to show you how I do it. If you are at all, if you like baking at all and like anything pumpkin, these are a definite try. They'd be perfect too for like a hostess gift if you're going somewhere. So like I mentioned, this was the night before. This was on Friday night. I was tired and didn't really feel like making these muffins, but I'm so glad I did because they were so nice to have the next morning, and we had them throughout the week for snacks and breakfast. So I'm going to include the recipe below in the description box, but this pumpkin pie spice is kind of like the one little key ingredient that makes it so, so good. I'm pretty sure you can buy pumpkin pie spice mix, like already pre-made, but I make it only because I just happen to have all the ingredients. Actually, to be totally honest, I don't think I had cloves, but I made it anyway, and it was totally fine. I'll include down below also just how you make the pumpkin pie spice if you want to make your own. So again, just mixing all the dry ingredients. It's all just super standard ingredients. The only things you might not have on hand are that pumpkin pie mix spice, and it also requires coconut oil, which is right here. A lot of people I think have coconut oil already. We don't normally have it. I basically buy it for this recipe mainly because it's really expensive. So if you don't have it, I have made these muffins with regular like vegetable oil before, and they're totally fine. It changes like the density of them. Like I do prefer them with the coconut oil, but if you're in a pinch or if you just don't have the budget for the coconut oil, they will definitely work with any type of oil. So the reason I actually started making these muffins in the first place was because I had a ton of pumpkin in my freezer. I, after Halloween, will cut up our pumpkins and like roast them and puree them and put them in the freezer, which is awesome because you have a ton of free pumpkins. Pumpkin puree is not cheap. So I usually do that. However, it is only September, so I don't have any pumpkin in my freezer. So I just use the pumpkin puree from the store, and it still tasted really, really good. So as soon as we were done breakfast, the first thing we did was swap out our wreath to our fall one. The one you see here is our summer wreath that I leave on all summer long. The one thing I did with this year is it's a super light wreath. I don't know if anyone has something like this. It's almost basically foam. And see the magnets on the back? I added them those here because this would scratch the heck out of our door. Anytime it was windy, it would blow everywhere and scratch the metal. So I added magnets to the back, and this is the first year I did it, and it worked like a charm. So if anybody has a wreath problem, give it a shot. It was totally worth it. Next, we just did a quick clean of our door because it gets so gross. And you can see we're adding our fall wreath. What you always do differently is we have one of the little magnetic hooks because, as I mentioned, we have a metal door, but we put it on the inside of the door so it's not kind of like an eyesore on the outside. It's sort of hidden. And then we just use a fishing line and kind of wrap it around the top of the door. And it works awesome. We've been doing that kind of since we moved in here. So if you have a metal door and you have one of these magnetic hooks, I love it because it kind of looks like you have a floating wreath and it stays really well. So give it a shot. Next thing we did was to just get rid of our patio furniture in the back. This is our backyard and we just have a simple little deck with some patio furniture out there, and we just want to tuck it away for the winter. We just keep it in the garage. And to be totally honest, we didn't use this patio furniture a lot this year. It's just like kind of a traditional set. We got it as a hand-me-down from Scott's parents, and it's great. There's absolutely nothing wrong with it. We just don't eat outside, I find, a lot. I'm not sure if it's or doesn't back onto our kitchen or what, but I would say maybe we sat here twice. So I'm thinking maybe for next year, I kind of might rethink what we do in the back. If you guys have any cool ideas of what you do in your backyard, in your patio, like what kind of furniture you have and how you have it set up, let me know below. Like I like this set, as I mentioned, but it's just, we don't tend to eat out there. We tend to kind of just hang out sometimes, but never for meals. So we'll see. Anyway, as you can see, we're just tossing it into the garage for the winter. Next up was pumpkin shopping. Annie Rose and I headed out to Giant Tiger. If you're in Canada, you would probably know what that is. If you are not, Giant Tiger is basically just like a local, like Canadian discount store. So kind of like a mini Walmart, I guess. So it's super close to our house, so we tend to go there a lot for stuff. So the boys stayed at home and Annie Rose and I just popped out to see what we could find. There was this little tiny section with some mini pumpkins, which is kind of what I get for the indoor. So I got one little bag of the mini pumpkins to use just kind of for our indoor, and I think these were $4 for that. And then we went to the back to find the big pumpkins, and we got two of those for the outside of our house for our outside fall decor. Next up, everyone, we went to the apple orchard. We are super lucky and live super close to a really, really nice apple orchard and kind of like pumpkin patch. We go pretty much every year, and I actually grew up going to the same place. As you can see, you can kind of see behind all the houses and trees, there's a huge body of water there, and we live really close to the water, which again, super lucky. So we just did a quick drive out to do some apple picking, and which we kind of do every year. As you can see, it's a gorgeous place. You're probably wondering, why didn't you just buy your pumpkins here, Marianne? However, I purposely went out and bought them beforehand because pumpkins are expensive at the pumpkin patch, and I get taken over. The pumpkin patch takes over and it makes me want to buy 10, 20 pumpkins. So I purposely went out and bought them ahead of time so I wouldn't even be tempted when we got there. So we just went on our wagon ride and picked some apples to save us a little bit of money. So as you can see, the kids had a blast. It's such a cute little spot. It's not cheap, I will say, and it can be really expensive. So we did skip a couple of years of going, but we put it back in our budget this year, and I'm glad we did because we actually had a really good time. And it was perfect weather-wise, so we got really lucky. One other thing that this orchard has that we love is cider. So Scott and I can enjoy a little tasting of cider while the kids have their snack and play, and that's a big bonus for the two of us that we love. Next, we just came home, and as you can see, I cleaned a ton of apples. I now have 10 pounds of apples. Send me your apple recipes. I don't know what to do with them all. We eat a ton of apples, so I'm sure they won't go bad or anything. But the other thing I do with the apples is I always, usually for the entire month of October, I have them as a centerpiece on our dining room table. So it's just like an easy way to make the house look festive without spending any money and without any waste or anything like that, which I love. Next up, I made chili. So I put some chili on for dinner. This chicken chili is unbelievable. It is so good. We've been making it for a few years now. I got the recipe originally from the Minimal Mom. If you don't already follow her videos, she's amazing. And I've kind of tweaked the recipe a few different times. I'll put it in the description box below. This time I used 2 cans of black beans. I change up kind of whatever beans you're in the mood for. Sometimes I use some chickpeas in there too. I will say I was talking to a girl from work who made it, and it is super thick, so I should warn you about that, which I love. I have tend to kind of try to thin it out by over the years of making it, and I tend to add like a little bit of water, as you can see I use from the salsa bottle, like the salsa jar, and or sometimes I just don't drain like the corn and beans, and that tends to also make it like a little bit thinner as well. While I was making the chili, the kids wanted to decorate their little mini pumpkins, so they each got one of their pumpkins and they just used their markers. And you can see Annie Rose had her jammies on because she wore them for nap. So nothing elaborate about this pumpkin decorating. It's literally just markers on pumpkins. They use dry erase markers actually on some of them, so we could kind of remove it and then do them again. And I am definitely not a crafty mom. I try to keep that pretty simple, but then all I did was clean off our mantle. That's where we keep all of our artwork during the week, and pretty much every weekend I clear that off and get rid of all the school stuff. And then here I put on our little mini pumpkins. Super simple, but just made it a little bit festive for the season. And our last little white pumpkin, and this is like our front main entryway table. And then for that last hour, kind of before dinner, on the weekends, I love to just have that time to just be at home and kind of after, especially after a really busy day, we've had lots of fun and done lots of chores, and I just kind of like to chillax. And in this case, do laundry, which is never ending. I have a whole video just on our laundry routine. If you haven't seen it, I will link it below. But it's pretty simple, and I actually don't hate folding laundry, so I tend to just do that while we have kind of sports on. Scott usually has baseball or something, and the kids are just messing around playing. Eros is usually helping or not helping, and I just find like that as kind of one little relaxing part of my day, especially I find in the fall and winter. I tend to do that more often because it's kind of a cozier season and I don't feel like going back out of the house. That's how we often end our weekend days on Saturdays and Sundays. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time.
We're gonna stay right here. Goodbye. Thanks. Bye. Say thanks for watching. Bye. Thanks for watching.
Bye.
See you next time.
See you next time.
See you next time.
See you next time.